Hi guys, so today I'm going to be doing a slightly detailed reading on love. So the question is, why are you drawn to this person, and are they also as drawn to you? So we have like three piles here, but all of them are like divided in two. So you and your person, right? So there are three piles: pile one, pile two, and pile three. Pile one is the lapis lazuli stone. Pile two is the rose quartz. And pile three is the smoky quartz pyramid. All right, I would like you to please pause your cameras and pick your pile. Why are you drawn to this person, and are they drawn to you back? All right. Right, so let's start with pile one. Okay, so pile one with the lapis lazuli. So this is going to be you and your person. Let's see. Okay, Gaia nurturing. This is your person's two of pentacles. I think I'm going to do this after I see yours. Okay, I don't want too many cards. They kind of distract me, too many cards. So I'm going to just do it in a pile, one by one. Gratitude, honor the sacred in every creation, the corn goddess. So why are you drawn to your person? This is what we are looking at right now. Nine of cups. Three of Swords, Earth Magic, Fairies. Okay. Please give me a minute. All right, so pile one. Why are you so drawn to your person? All right. Now, I feel that there is a sense here of you being thankful for having this person in your life. All right. I sense with the Three of Swords that it's possible that this person came into your life when, you know, you were going through some sort of a heartbreak or some painful moment in your life, painful time in your life, maybe. You might have been in third party situations or something like that. You know, there was a lot of pain when this person came, and this person was almost like, you know, like a fairy or an angel for you, because, you know, I'm seeing with the Earth Magic card here, it's almost like, you know, this person finally sees the light. All right. It's like this light is being beamed down upon this person, and they finally see the light and transform. So I sense that your person has been a sort of helper or something like that in your life, okay? Maybe they came to you when it was that time in life when you were really heartbroken about something, pained about something, and they kind of showed you the light, they showed you the path or something like that. All right. It's even possible that they made you transform from this energy into something more ethereal. I'm seeing magic here, you know, so it's also possible that, you know, there was something spiritual here. You know, maybe they showed you or they gave you some sort of, you know, way forward, a light at the end of the tunnel, maybe in terms of spirituality or counseling or something like that. I sense that this person was almost like godsend for you guys, you know, and I see you guys very grateful to this person. It says the corn goddess, honor the sacred in every connection, in every creation. Sorry, why did I say connection? I think this is a sacred connection. I think that's the reason, because I sense this is definitely a sacred connection. It's a sacred relationship, and you know that, pile one. All right, you know this, and you are actually it's growing by the day. I mean, I'm seeing with the corn goddess, it's almost like, you know, when I see this person, I'm seeing, you know, she's holding this, I don't know, jewelry or something here, and it's kind of hidden, but it's like a treasure this person is holding within herself. Right, and then I see a spiral here. So to me, this indicates like a past life connection. Maybe you guys were, you know, soulmates. You are definitely soulmates, you know, divine relationship, basically. You know, whatever label you want to use in that, this is a divine relationship. It's almost like this person has been sent or was sent in your life to kind of guard you or get you out of some painful energies, I sense. And pile one, I think you still hold a candle to them. Now, the thing is, I don't know if they are in your life. I do sense maybe they might be, but somewhere in the distance. I don't know why. I mean, it's almost like, you know, when I see the star constellation here, it's almost like, you know, they are the star, they are the guiding star for you. They represent hope, they represent love, or, you know, they represent something like something to look forward to, and you know that they're always there. You know, maybe there is a psychic telepathic connect here as well, you know, because I'm seeing this wolf figure or dog figure, whatever it is, you know, somewhere in the background, and you know, you are confidently moving on ahead. And it's almost like you're offering gratitude to the universe for sending this person in your life. With the orange in this card, I'm also sensing, you know, there might be sexual attraction here from your side. I sense, okay, there is a romantic tinge here as well. But somehow, you know, this card tells me that the coming of this person in your life kind of boosted your confidence. Okay, you kind of came out of your shell of this painful energy, and they kind of acted like a conduit or something for the divine to get you into this, you know, a beautiful, powerful self that you are. Like, I'm seeing like you almost, you know, unfolded like this flower, you know, bloomed like this flower, transformed. I'm seeing transformation here. So this person might have come to you at that kind of time in your life where, you know, you were going through this transformation, and they probably assisted you by showing you some light or some answers or something like that. Okay, I'm also seeing like a guardian angel figure here for, you know, with this dog here and this figure here. I'm also seeing it's possible like this person is a sort of guardian angel for you, earth angel for you, something like that. This is a very, very light and beautiful energy, and this is all purple and pink. So this is also reminding me of spirituality. There's something sacred about this connection, I said, and you're very grateful for it, pile one. And you know, the thing is that with this nine of cups, I sense that, you know, like this is for you, the coming of this person for you was like a wish fulfillment, or maybe in the future you are hoping that you will get together with this person, and being with the person is going to be like a wish fulfillment for you. Your nine of cups, your dreams achieved, you know, and you feeling more than ever confident about yourself. So I don't know what is the situation with the three of cups. I do sense that it's possible that, you know, this person might be, I don't know, in another connection, or you might be in another connection, and that's why this union cannot happen. But you have hope of that, I sense. You have hope of this happening, because this is like a kind of wish fulfillment for you. I sense you're also manifesting this person somewhere in your life, you know, because I see gratitude card here. So it's almost like you're giving offerings to the divine to manifest this wish fulfillment in your life. You're almost, for some of you, I also sense, I don't know, I mean, this is for a small number of you. I also sense that maybe you guys are doing some manifestation work, like some earth magic or something, because you are no longer, you know, in this heartbreak energy. You have claimed your power, you have reclaimed your power, and now you want the best in your life, all right? And now you are asking, I don't know if you know this person. If you know this person, you are definitely manifesting them. If you don't know this person also, you know, maybe you're manifesting a soulmate, you know. And I sense that even if you don't know this person, you are manifesting and creating this person at this time. Pile one, you are done with, you know, confusing relationships, heartbreaking relationships. You're stepping into your power and you're manifesting something that you want, which is going to be your wish fulfillment. Okay, so this could be a person you have not met as well, but you know, if you have met this person, you are manifesting this person. But to recap, the reason why you're drawn to this person is because they were like, you know, some sort of a rescuer, an angel, a path shower, a light bringer kind of person in your life. Okay. And also, I feel that, you know, this is a sacred connection, all right? This has lifetimes. You've had past lifetimes with this person, and there is a draw. There's a very primal draw that you feel towards this person because you've shared past lives, and they are like, you know, bought into your life because of certain major transformations you were going through. And somehow, energetically, I sense that, you know, you guys are like a very good match to each other, but for some reason I'm sensing that, you know, there is something else here, you know, the reason why you're not together. But I sense you're very hopeful. Yes, you're very attracted, you're very drawn, you're very magnetized towards this person. You're hoping for the best in the future. You're even, maybe some of you might even be manifesting this person. But I feel that there is some, you know, blockage here. So I don't know, maybe with time this is going to clear up. But I do feel that, you know, this person is someone you have had many past lives with. You could even have had like a childhood with this person. And, you know, when you met at a certain point of time, maybe either you or they were in other connections. So this could not come together. But I'm seeing a very light energy here, you know, with you kind of not having any negative feelings about this person. Okay, you are very positive about them. Now, let's see, what is your person? What are they equally drawn to you? Let's see that. Two of Pentacles. I hope this fits, guys. Okay. Gaia, nurturing. You hold in your heart a space to be filled, empty nest. And the Hanged Man. All right. Okay. All right. So this is pretty straightforward, actually. This looks to me like your person is probably in another connection. All right. Because I'm seeing this Two of Pentacles here. So it's possible, you know, you guys met, you know, after they were already committed to somebody or inner connection or something on those lines. All right. So this was something they had to manage, you know, while they were in that other connection. So there is a sense of an off and on here. Maybe your person reaches out to you sometimes, maybe they don't, because of, you know, another connection in their life, maybe a, you know, relationship or a marriage or some other. It could even be a situation. Please apply it as it fits. Now I feel with this Gaia nurturing, I feel this person really cares for you. All right. And I think you feel that. I mean, we did mention that, you know, there is a very guardian angel kind of quality here. So with this Gaia nurturing, I do feel that your person, this person has like both their hands on like earth, kind of sending energies to earth. So it's almost like they are a guardian angel to you. They have those feelings for you as well, you know, that they need to nurture you, protect you, care for you. And you know, even if you pair up these two cards here, it's almost like, you know, there is this light coming to this person. This is you, and this is the person sending the light. So yes, this person is very drawn to you. They find there's a very protective energy here. So I mean, you know, apply it as it fits, like, you know, who, what this connection is. It could even be a friendship, it could be a relative, or it could be a romantic connection. For most of you, obviously, I sense it's a romantic connection, because otherwise there wouldn't be a blockage, right? But this person, you know, wants to provide, protect you, nurture you, you know, like take care of you. They kind of think of you as this delicate flower kind of thing, you know, like I'm getting a very like you know, they see you as this fairy or delicate creature, and they want to nurture you, they want to protect you. This person has very strong feelings of caring for you and providing for you and things like that. Okay, now with this card, you hold in your heart a space to be filled. So yeah, this person does hold a space in your heart, in their heart for you. Okay, it's almost like, you know, I'm seeing like this star-crossed thing where, you know, both of you are an energetic match, but somehow because of circumstances, please apply the circumstances as they fit, but somehow due to circumstances, this person, you know, is not able to come towards you, and they still hold this beautiful place in their heart for you. They have a candle lit for you in their heart. And I think you know this. I mean, if you see, this person is looking very preoccupied and, you know, looking into their feelings, into the cup they have of emotions. And this person is, you know, like very confident of this person's love. All right. I see this person looking at them from there. So it's possible you have a psychic telepathic connection, but this person holds a lot of emotions for you, and maybe that is also one of the reasons why you guys are so drawn to this person. There's an incredibly protective energy about this connection. Somehow I'm sensing, you know, it's almost like it's almost like, you know, this person is like safeguarding their feelings. I don't know if they have told you about this. It's possible that they might not have, because they are in something else at this point. But I'm feeling that, you know, this person's almost safeguarding their feelings for you in this connection. Okay. And it's like it's hidden in a cave kind of a thing. And this person is kind of nurturing their emotions for you. So this could be a person who has not told you. I'm getting a sense maybe this person might not have told the exact extent of their feelings for you, but there's a very protective vibe. It's a yearning I'm sensing, you know. It's almost like a yearning here. It's like this person thinks of you in their quiet time when they're withdrawn from the world. These emotions come up, okay, and they're always like kind of worried about you, trying to figure out what is up with you, and you know, like not always in communication, but probably, you know, once in a while reaching out, okay, and that kind of empowers you, I sense, okay. So, and with these orangish energies, pinkish orangish energies, there is mutual attraction here as well. There's romantic attraction here. If this is a romantic pile, then there is romantic attraction as well from your person's side. And this person, it says empty nest here, okay. So this person's heart is empty, you know, and you hold a place in their heart, okay. So yeah, this is a very mutual connection, very mutual. But for some reason I'm sensing that this person cannot do anything about it at this time. With the Hanged Man, it's almost like, you know, there is stagnation, there is this energy of, you know, wanting to do something, but knowing that, you know, they can't do anything at this point. And I think it kind of comes from this situation because, I don't know, please apply this situation as it fits. But because of this situation, I sense your person can't do anything about it for the moment. Okay, so they are like just being in this. They're just flowing with this. All right. And yes, you do sense that there might be something that this person will do in the future. But, you know, at this point, you know, I think this person is not really able to do anything. I'm going to just check, you know, what might happen. I'll just pull some cards. I don't like shuffling on camera, but, you know, like I'm just going to pull some cards and see what's going to happen in the future in this connection. Temperance, the Hermit, and the okay, bottom of the deck is Knight of Swords. All right, so the thing is, I'm seeing that, you know, the parting, the reason that both of you are not together at this point is because, you know, there is some balancing that both of you have to do. All right, in your respective areas in life, you need to do some balancing, and there is going to be a period of maybe withdrawal or maybe just a light friendship in the future. They're all three major arcana cards, if you can see. Okay, but after that, I am seeing this connection blooming. All right, it's almost like with the Empress, finally it's time for this connection to bloom, to come into its rightful place, I'm hearing. Okay, this is also a number three, and this is also a number three, so I'm sensing there's something to do with the number three here. So it's possible it's like you know, it could be 3 weeks, 3 months, or even 3 years. Okay, take it as it resonates, but this connection is going to come into fruition in the future, I am seeing. All right, but before that, I do sense there might be withdrawal, there might be soul seeking, there might be shadow work, there might be balancing. It's a very twin flame soulmate type of connection. It's a sacred connection, and we did establish that earlier. Okay, but this connection has a lot of potential in the future. It is going to come into fruition in the future, I sense. Okay, pile one. All right, that was interesting. So now let's go to pile two. Okay, so pile two, people. Okay, it's getting tough to shift these cards with these two piles, but it's okay, it's all right. All right, so pile two with the rose quartz. All right, let's see why are you drawn to this person, and what do they feel back for you? So, okay, we will see about your person later. We'll see about you at this point. Break the negative cycle. Two of Swords. The Empress. And Solitude. Okay. Please give me a minute so I can see this. Okay, so the first thing that I'm getting here, pile two, right? The reason that you are drawn to this person is mainly, I don't know why, I'm seeing that this is something like a karmic kind of a connection, I sense. All connections are karmic in nature, but this is something to do with breaking of a pattern or a cycle or something that you have formed with this person in a past life. I'm seeing incredible attraction. Maybe this person might be very attractive to look at, I sense, with the Empress card here. I also feel a lot of, like, there is a sort of feeling of looking up to this person, because maybe they're very confident or very popular or very good looking or something like that. All right, but I sense that, you know, it's been like you don't have clarity, you know, or they don't have clarity. Please take it as it resonates. If you've approached this person, I don't think they are very clear about what they want from you, okay? Because I'm seeing their heart blocked off, and this could be you as well. It's almost like, you know, you want this person, you're so drawn to this person, you find them incredibly attractive and beautiful and, you know, all of that, and you probably even want to make them your spouse or something like that, but somehow it just doesn't happen. You know, it's blocked off. This connection is blocked off, all right? And you always seem to remain in solitude here, you know, just wondering what is it that this person feels. So this is looking like some sort of a bit, I mean, this could be a little triggering, and it is for some of you, not all of you, okay? But it's looking a little like a codependent thing where, you know, like a person you're very attracted to doesn't make up their mind, but you know that there is something here, you know. So I'm sensing from this pile that, you know, you sense that there is something that this person has for you, okay? Like, I'm seeing this person, like, you know, like not really seeing anything, blocking their heart away, and there is this, but there is this river of emotion behind, river or any kind of water body indicates emotion, all right? So it's almost like you sense that this person has something for you, and I'm seeing water here as well, all right? You sense that this person has something for you, and that there could be something that could bloom from this, but nothing is coming out of it, you know. I feel that you just remain in the dark about this person. But since you feel intuitively, maybe, or through their actions, that there is something, you keep coming back to this person, you keep getting drawn to this person, maybe, and you just don't understand why it is that, you know, you just keep coming back, even when there is no clarity. Okay, now it says break the negative cycle. Okay, I'm seeing that it says mount of the white horse, break the negative cycle. So yeah, you need to, like, you know, break the cycle of constantly being in the dark about this person. So if they are not sure about you and they've asked for time, I mean, maybe set a time limit and then you know, take a call. Don't wait forever. Or if you, you know, if they have not said anything, then you need to decide what to do. Because I do feel you will decide after some time, because I'm seeing, you know, this light coming here. So there is a sense of clarity that is going to come, I sense, in the future. But we will see, you know, in the next few cards how it works. So I feel this is like a very cloudy situation. I don't know, I mean, it's like nothing is clear, yet you feel there is something, and this is a cycle you guys need to break. Pile two. Okay, even if this person has something for you, they are at this point of time not telling you anything. We will check in the cards what it is that they feel for you. But I really feel that, you know, until this person doesn't tell you what it is they want, you need to, like, break this cycle of staying in this confusion and in this blocked off state. You know, waiting for something to bloom in the future. I really feel you need to break this cycle. You know, it's coming up strongly here that yes, there is something here. Okay, I definitely see that there's something because there is emotion here. But it's like when the person is refusing to see it, then what do you do? You know, what can you do? Okay, this person holds some sort of a magnetic power to you, you know, to... I mean, they exert some sort of power over you, I sense. There is a sense of like putting this person on a pedestal. Maybe they're popular. Maybe they're... I don't know. I mean, they just look a little out of reach for you guys, pile two. So I'm not sure, you know. Please apply the situation as it fits. It's possible even that you are the one who is, you know, more popular, more vivacious, you know, out there, very abundant, very giving. But this person is the one who is confused and blocked off. All right. And just unable to decide for you or not. And that kind of makes you feel, you know, lonely and dejected, you know, like an island, as though, you know, like... you want the person, but you know they are not sure, and you know, because of whatever past issues they have. And so, you know, what do you do? What do you do, right? So there is that scenario that I'm seeing as well, but you need to get out of it. Okay, I'm also seeing for some of you guys that it's possible that, you know, this, you guys could be secret admirers of this person. You know, like I'm seeing with the Two of Swords and Solitude, it's almost like, you know, you guys might be watching this person from afar. And maybe this person doesn't know you at all, you know. And if that is the case, this is for a very small number of you. But, you know, like if that is the case, then you need to break this cycle and do something about it. I mean, decide. Because Two of Swords is like, you know, a decision is something like a decision that you have to make. You know, do you want to go forward and maybe experience a new beginning with this person? Maybe they will respond to you. So maybe you need to decide and get away from this solitude. Pile two. Okay, that is another scenario I'm seeing. Break the negative cycle of indecision and go forward, and you know, like just express yourself, express your feelings to this person and gain some clarity. I mean, you know, I see the clarity coming. So maybe you guys will break this cycle and, you know, come out of this, you know, confusion energy, and maybe there will be a blooming after that. You never know, right? So this is the reason I'm seeing for you guys to be, you know, like there are 3-4 scenarios. Please apply them as they fit. But this is the reason why you are so drawn to this person. Okay. Now let's see what this person feels for you. Remove the mask of your everyday persona. Five of Cups, Page of Swords, Emergence. Interesting. So what does this person feel for you? Okay, so I'm seeing that, you know, this person, pile two, I feel this person, either you don't know them truly, like I said, you know, it might be a secret admirer, kind of, you might be secret admirers, or, you know, this person might be someone you have not gotten to know yet, okay, truly. Because I'm seeing remove the mask of your everyday persona. This person, I mean, you are probably seeing only one side of this person. You don't know the inner self of this person because this person is showing an everyday persona to you. They have not shown you their true self, all right? This person is someone who is actually You know, maybe because I'm not sensing like a relationship vibe here, but it's possible that, you know, you might have had a relationship at one time and now you guys are at a distance or, you know, not in connection, and that's why you don't know what's going on with this person. But I sense that your person has not shown you and does not at this point want to show you their true self. All right, because maybe there is nothing set in stone here in terms of a connection. So yeah, that is one thing. Now, I do feel with this Five of Cups energy, it's possible for some of you that you guys, if you've had a connection, if you've had a relationship with this person, then it's possible that the person is, you know, like, looking at what happened in the past and ignoring what is there, you know, that you have to offer. They're too, you know, like, they're very emotional about what happened in the past. You know, maybe they're still holding on to grudges or holding on to what happened, you know, because I'm seeing sadness here in the Five of Cups, grief almost. So this could be in your connection with this person, and if you've not had a relationship with them, then it could be another connection that is hurting this person, all right? And that's the reason why they're turned away from what you have to offer, okay? So I'm seeing these two scenarios with your person. Your person is internally, I think externally, your person might be acting quite different from what they are feeling internally. This person's not very happy at this point. Okay. Now, with the dragonfly emergence, I am seeing that, you know, your person might take some time to emerge into their feelings for you. All right, it's going to take them time, because if you see, this person's like coming out of the water, this dragonfly is emerging, all right, it's unfurling, all right, so it's possible it's going to take time for your person, because I sense that, you know, this person is just gone through something, either with you or, you know, with someone else. And they're hurt right now. I don't think they're in a position. It's not necessary it's a relationship. It could be any situation which was very painful for your person, you know, which has kind of kept, which is keeping them stuck. All right. Yes, there is emotion here. It's a Cups card. There is emotions. You are sensing, right, that there is something, because, but, and here also I see water. Okay. So, yeah, I mean, there's a lot of water. Your person's a very emotional person, the one that you are asking about. Pile two, this person's very emotional, all right? They don't show themselves to, you know, the world very much. I sense they might be in this Empress energy. They might show a very different side to them than what they are inside, okay? And I feel that this person's kind of trying to heal right now and maybe needs that solitude, which I sense that, you know, maybe if you are the one who is the vivacious one and this is the one who's closed off, this is the reason why this person is closed off. There is some darkness in their life, okay? From wherever it comes, you know, please apply it as it fits. And if you don't know, this is the cards telling you that there is something, and this person will take some time to emerge, or to emerge into their feelings for you, okay? Because this person's not ready at this time. All right, they're still emerging from their, you know, whatever happened or whatever is happening. The positive thing about this person is that they are going to be emerging out of this. They're no longer going to be looking at these spilled cups. They're going to be, you know, turning their back to this, turning their front to their eyes to these two cups. All right, they're going to be emerging out of this, you know, like dark emotions, right? So I do feel also for some of you, I sense this person has something for you, but it's kind of on a very, you know, like a subconscious sort of level, okay? They're not yet aware or something like that. Obviously, if you don't know this person, then they would not be. But if you know this person and if you've expressed your feelings to this person, you know, they are somewhere, you know, like there is something hidden in the subconscious of this person in terms of their feelings for you, but it has yet to emerge because, you know, they need to get out of this energy. Right now, when I see the Page of Swords, this person, you have sparked this person's curiosity, okay? Because Page of Swords is an energy of, like, you know, someone looking at your social media, someone wanting information about you, trying to gather information, you know, something like that. Or it could even be just intuitive hits that this person is getting about you. But something about you has kind of like piqued their curiosity at this point. I'm not seeing like a full-blown, like a, you know, love connection or deep feelings or anything like that. But I do feel this person is like, you know, like curious about you. So I don't know if you reached out to this person or not, but this person has some idea. I don't know on what level they have it, but they have some idea about, you know, you, and they're interested. They're curious, rather. Not interested. Interested is not the right word. Curious is more the word I would get. Okay. But I feel once they come out of this, you know, Five of Cups energy, there is a lot of, you know, like chances, a lot of potential for this person to like you back and to be drawn to you as well. Okay, but at this point of time, I feel that, you know, this person just, you know, like wants their solitude. Okay, or you want your solitude. Please apply it as it fits. Okay, but there is potential here. So let us see, you know, let us see. I also feel, you know, that somewhere, something in you senses that this person is a little sad and, you know, like not really showing their true self. And that is also one of the things that draws you to them. You know, like you want to help this person. Maybe you feel their sadness, you know, maybe you feel their solitude and you want to do something because you care about this person. But then, you know what, you know, like you can only help so much. You need to break for yourself. You need to get out of this cycle because, you know, this person needs to help themselves at this time. All right. Nobody, no external help is going to help this person. All right. They have to come out of it by themselves, and they will. Okay. I'm seeing emergence. I'm seeing healing with this. All right. So, yeah. So this person is kind of curious about you is what I'm getting mostly, but, you know, and there is potential for the future. So let's see, like, what might happen in this connection in the future. Let's see. Okay, Five of Pentacles, the Moon, Knight of Wands. All right, I like that. And bottom of the deck is Four of Swords. So yeah, there is not much activity going on here in this connection. I do feel that in the future, it's possible that there is going to be distance here. There is going to be solitude. I don't see you guys meeting here. I see distance, maybe. You know, you feeling left out, in the cold, not good enough or something like that. Or they feeling that. I am seeing, you know, like emotions going up and down in this connection. I definitely see distance here. There might be some psychic telepathic contact. I feel there is something about intuition in this pile, so please take it as it resonates. But I do sense distance here, okay? But then there is communication, okay? I do feel that, you know, either you or them are going to communicate. There's something coming up here. With the Knight of Wands, this is a passionate beginning, all right? So this might relate to anything. It might be a beginning in communication, or this might be the expression of feelings either from their side or your side. But there is activity. After a period of stagnation, I'm definitely seeing activity and a willingness to, remove this confusion either from your side or from their side. All right. So there is some activity happening. It's a passionate beginning. It's a new beginning. And it's very positive. I am seeing Wands energy is fire energy. So after all of this, emotions and darkness, I am seeing some sort of headway in the future. All right. So whatever that is, we are not going to go into that right now. But I do feel that there is something coming in the future. Might be at any time. I mean, it could be, I sense with the moon card here, it could be 9 days, 9 weeks, or 9 months. All right, so take it as it resonates. This is what I'm seeing. So this is what I see for pile two. So let me know when something happens in this connection, because I'm intrigued. Okay. All right, so let's go to pile three. Okay, so pile number three. Sorry for the noise, stuff to move to. Two piles together. Okay. So pile three with the smoky quartz. Okay. Why are you so drawn to this person? So let us see. So this is your person's. We'll see it later. This is yours. Let's see. Magdalene de la Mer, go forward and leave the past behind. The Artist, Six of Cups, I'm so sorry, it's just hit the camera, I keep hitting the camera. All right. Ancestors, generations. Okay, so right off the bat, pile three, this is like a very, very ancient connection. The reason why you're drawn to this person is because you have you have this whole past story. It's been running since generations. I mean, if you can see, it's almost like, I'm seeing like this is a very connected, threaded connection through across lifetimes, across generations, maybe even, past lives. I'm seeing past lives in this. All right. This is definitely a soul connection. This is a divine connection, maybe, primary soulmates or twin flames. This is very connected, very threaded. This is the first card that I'm drawn to. So it's almost like, with the Six of Cups is also for me a past life card. So to me, it seems as though, you guys might have had like past lives together. You might have had generations with this person, maybe children with this person as well. So yeah, I am seeing that the reason why you're drawn to this person is because yours is a very sacred soulmate, primary soulmate connection, which has roots stretching back to lifetimes. Okay. I don't know if you actually subscribe to past lives, but if you do, then this is what is the main thing that I'm seeing. Now, with the Artist card here, I feel that this is a connection that is, the artist is like the creator, okay? Someone who's painting something, someone who's creating something. This is an extra card in this deck. It's almost like this connection has been around since the beginning of time or something like that, okay? It's like, it's a work of art, all right? It's a sort of something that has been, you know, like you keep putting in the brush strokes to actually make the full painting. So it's almost like this connection has been created, you know, since the beginning of time. And every lifetime, you know, there is a layer added to it. I'm seeing this tree. It's also a very densely rooted tree. So trees also remind me of ancestry and generations. So like right off the bat, I mean, all these cards are like, you know, talking about soulmates and twin flames. To be frank, this is my twin flame pile. I don't know why all my pile threes are extremely spiritual piles. Okay, there's something about the number three I sense. All right. Now, when I see this go forward and leave the past behind, I'm seeing that, you know, there is some sadness associated with this connection. I don't know. Maybe you guys are not together, or I'm sensing distance here. I mean, I don't know if you're, you know, in connection with your person, but I'm not sensing any kind of a tangible contact here. All right, but you feel it in your heart. And I'm seeing these two storks or cranes or whatever, they're like, you know, threaded, they're like intermingled with each other. It's almost like the two of cups that I'm seeing over here. So this is like a twin flame. This is giving me a twin flame vibe here. Please apply it as it fits, whatever label you want. This is a very threaded connection. I mean, it's like been going on for lifetimes and lifetimes. I sense you have even past life memories of this person. You might be meeting them in the 5D or something like that. You know, this is something that is incredibly connected and also very telepathic. There's something about telepathy and psychic insights coming through, you catching this person's energies. But there is heartache here because I sense sadness in this person's face, and you know, it's like she's holding a rose. So there is a memory of this connection, but maybe the person is not with you, and that is the reason why, you know, you are sad and pining and longing for this person, I sense. Yeah. But the thing is that what I'm seeing here is this horse who's watching this person. So it's almost like, you know, your person sees you, and I don't know how that is possible. Please apply it to your situation the way it fits, because you guys are connected somewhere. When I see this talk analogy here, or you know, it's like your energies are intermingled somewhere, and you know, this person's watching you, pile three. You are not aware of this, but this person sees you. So I don't know what is this situation. Please apply it as it fits. With the bird traveling, I feel you might get a message from this person soon or something like that, but you are almost like treasuring, you know, either memories of the time that you were together with this person, or even memories of the time when, you know, you might have had even past life memories with this person. And you are kind of treasuring them at this time. And, you know, they're asking you to go forward and leave the past behind. So it's possible for some of you, it's possible that this is a, you know, you were together at one point of time with this person. That's the second scenario I'm getting. It's possible you were together with this person, you created a home, you might have had children with this person, but maybe due to something it didn't work out. You know, either the person left, or you know, something happened to the person or something like that. There is sadness here. I don't know why I'm sensing sadness. All right, it's like you pine for this person. I'm not seeing any negative energies. I'm not even seeing energies of unrequited love here. I'm just seeing a lot of pining and, you know, like sorrow or just missing the person. So there might be children involved, I sense. You might have had children with this person. You might be, or they might, you know, I don't know, something like that. Okay, there's something about children here. Okay, and the creation of an ancestry, you know. So yes, I do feel that maybe you, for some of you, you know, there are children involved here, okay, and you miss the creation that you had with this person, but I don't know what is the situation and why is the person not with you. But there is this sense of sharing history with this person. The reason why you are so drawn to this person is because you share a history with this person. All right. If not just in this life, I feel maybe in many, many lifetimes, right up until the, you know, beginning of creation and, you know, whatever, you know, like, I don't want to overwhelm you guys, but I do feel that, you know, this is a very old, ancient type of a connection. It is definitely soulmates, it's definitely divine counterparts. I mean, if it is a romantic connection that you're looking at, that we're looking at, but this is something, you know, that it's almost like the past haunts you, all right? The memories of the past haunt you. And I don't know, I keep getting drawn to this card. This woman is also kept, you know, like a pot or around her, near her, with something in it, you know, some memories or something like that. But she has her back turned towards, you know, this connection. Actually, I don't know, maybe she doesn't realize that this can still happen. I don't know what is your situation, but I feel that it's almost like spirit is calling my attention to this, that it's possible that this might happen, because this person, someone is watching you, this person is watching you. So I don't know how that is possible. Okay, please apply it to your situation. But this was, I sense this is not unrequited love. This is definitely love that was there but is probably not there right now, and that causes some sort of a haunting feeling of, you know, like missing the person or longing or pining for the person, because this is a very, very ancient connection. Okay, so let's see what your person feels for you. Your goal is within reach. Queen of Cups, Knight of Cups, ouch, sorry, and Ceremony, Invocation. All right, okay. So actually, you know what, I was quite right about what, when I was saying this person is watching you, because the first card that comes to me is this Invocation. So I don't know what is this, but I mean, I don't know, maybe your person is into some sort of magic or something, but I'm just kidding. It's possible though, you know, for some of you, maybe this person is invoking you, manifesting you, creating you, or I don't know, something on those lines. I'm seeing magic here, okay? But on a more mundane level, I do feel that this person is kind of working, you know, in a very unique way, to bring you something or to manifest you in their life or something like that, you know. I'm definitely seeing this person manifesting you. Maybe they're doing law of attraction work, you know, maybe they're asking messages from their spirit guides, maybe they're getting psychic hits about you. You know, I told you this person is watching you. I do feel that this person has some sort of psychic sight or something like that, you know, and they are getting some sort of, they're invoking it, they're invoking their psychic senses or something, because I sense there's distance here. Okay, so your person is actually, maybe they meditate or something like that. And, you know, I'm seeing all these energies around this person. You know, I'm also seeing them, like, you know, healing with crystals or something like that. So I don't know, maybe your person is like a Reiki healer or something. I mean, this is just for some of you, very specific. But, you know, maybe they go to someone, you know, to sort of figure out something about you. I don't know why there is distance here. I'm a little interested, you know, like, I'm curious, why is there distance here? So whatever, I mean, you know, like this person, I feel like, you know, is trying to connect with you telepathically. Yeah, this person's doing everything they can to telepathically communicate with you somehow via spirit, through spirit. Okay, I'm getting that very strongly here. So, your person is very like, you know, you see a snake here, and you know, I see a snake coiled in here. So this person is aware of this connection. They're aware of the memories. You know, they're aware of this, whatever these memories were. I mean, either this is your past in this life or your past lives. You know, this person's very aware of this connection. All right, and they're trying to manifest it, I sense. All right, or even if they're not like manifesting it, like you know, through law of attraction or something, they are definitely aware, you know, of this connection. Something about your person is very psychic and intuitive, I sense. Okay, and or they are doing this via a psychic or intuitive, so it's possible they might be taking tarot readings about you or something like that. But your person wants to know more about you. They're invoking you, right? I mean, here you are almost like on the verge of giving up or something, feeling as though nothing's gonna happen. There's all this history and whatever. And here this person is like literally starting off a new beginning. I can't help but be drawn to this card because this is like the magician card actually in the tarot. All right, now, with the Knight of Cups and the Queen of Cups, all right, I'm seeing a lot of emotion here. All right, in fact, even this to me reminds me of the Ace of Cups. Okay, touch the grail, your goal is within reach. So it's like all cups, this card, this person's actually very, very much in love with you. All right, and with the Queen of Cups, once again, I feel that this person is definitely very psychic and very intuitive somewhere. Okay, very, very tuned in to spirit. So I don't know, this is something like a spiritual connection for sure. Your person is kind of monitoring you, I'm getting, you know, via their psychic intuitive senses. And there is a lot of love. They want to bring you this cup of love, you know, with the Knight of Cups. They want to come in like the knight in shining armor, and kind of like, you know, sweep you off your feet, kind of a thing, you know. I'm seeing that. But I feel with the Knight of Cups and the Queen of Cups here, it's almost like you are the Queen of Cups and they are the Knight of Cups, so they are a little lesser than you. You know, maybe this person is either younger to you or you are younger to them. Please take it as it resonates. But I sense that, you know, this person is kind of working towards, you know, being at your level, I sense. You know, because here also I get this card. It says your goal is within reach, touch the grail. So they are like working towards the grail. This is like the holy grail. It's like this is definitely a twin flame connection or something like that. Okay, so this person wants to come up to your level and offer you this cup of love actually. And I sense because there is no contact. I don't know the reason for no contact here, but I'm feeling that, you know, there is something about distance here. But this person wants to like reach this grail here first, okay? They want to be the perfect person first, equal to you, like the King of Cups. And then I sense that, you know, this person is going to come to you with this Ace of Cups kind of energy. All right, right now your person is headed towards you. They are trying to connect with you somehow, I sense, you know, so that you don't probably feel. They're trying to psychically connect with you. I'm getting this very strongly here. Okay, they are, maybe because they don't have any other means or something like that. But you know, it's almost like they want you not to lose hope. They don't want you to feel sad because, you know, like we saw that you guys are threaded and bonded together. So maybe this person catches your energies or something like that. I'm getting that very strongly, pile three, because this is a lot of water here. Okay, this is very spiritual. I think your person is some extra spiritual person. I think you are also quite psychic, intuitive, spiritual, but your person is like another level altogether, I sense. Okay, but you are like, you know, a little sad, but this person's coming towards you. I mean, if you see, you know, this person's watching you from here. This person, it's almost like also with this card, I'm sensing that, you know, this person, the angels are guiding them. There is something about this connection which is very divinely you know, guided or orchestrated, because, you know, it's almost like the angels are guiding them towards this grail, you know. So they are going step by step, and your person wants to reach you. They want to reach you. And so they are also telling you to go forward and leave the past behind. So I don't know what happened between you guys in this connection in the past, but you know, the negative energies of the past seem to be like troubling you a little bit. But this person is bringing something new to you, so they're asking you to move on from the negative energies. All right, but to recap, the reason why you're drawn to this connection, to this person, is because you guys are soulmates, very, very, very connected, and your person is also drawn to you. So it's almost like a magnetic attraction. And you know, this person's working towards coming to you. They watch you. You have a lot of psychic intuitive interaction. I don't know if you're aware, but I sense you are aware, because I did mention the 5D here. And both of these cards again are almost like the 5D to me. Okay, so there is something going on here very strongly. So let's see, what is the future of this connection? We had one card drop out. Ace of Cups. Judgment. Knight of Pentacles. Alright. Bottom of the deck, Page of Pentacles. Okay. Alright, so this fell out, as you can see. So this person's watching you. This is like a double confirmation that this person is watching you. I don't know how they're doing that, you know, maybe your social media, or I don't know, something like that. But it could even be psychically, like I was talking about. This person's watching you. But what is the future of this connection? I'm getting the Ace of Cups, which is an offer of love. We have like almost the Ace of Cups here, so that's a double confirmation. And I sense with the Judgment that this is going to happen like very suddenly. It's almost going to like awaken you out of this melancholy kind of an energy, like the sadness sort of stuff. You know, this person's going to come to you very suddenly with this, you know, they're going to reach out to you very suddenly with this Ace of Cups. They are right now watching you, trying to become your level or something like that. Maybe that's why there's no communication. But this person's coming towards you in the future, and it's going to happen very suddenly. There's something about the number 4 here, so please take it as it resonates. It could be in 4 weeks or 4 months. Okay, I don't think 4 years, but please take it as it resonates. But it's going to be very sudden, and it's going to be very unexpected. And it's a major arcana card, so it's going to be like a rebirth of this connection once again. And after that, I sense you guys are going to take it very slow and steady. You know, I mean, it's going to be like a shake up, and after that, it's going to be like you would need to calm down and, you know, take things very logically, very practically, because there is something so intensely psychic, intuitive about this connection that I sense it needs some sort of grounding. Okay. And the bottom of the deck, I did have Page of Pentacles also, which means that there is some sort of a offer that this person is going to make to you. It could be like a marriage proposal, I sense, or it could even be a gift, or it could even be a business offer. Okay, I mean like a work offer or something on those lines I'm seeing. Okay, so yeah, so this is going to happen for you. Pile number 3, this is simply beautiful. I'm just loving the way the cards have fallen here. I mean, it's brilliant. Okay, and it's been amazing doing this reading. Thank you so much. Very interesting pile 3, by the way. Okay, so please let me know how it resonates. Bye bye.